Oh, hi. Ever wonder why it always seems like the hot people are always such jerks? This is Jordan Ellenberg's example of Bergson's fallacy.
My name's Kine. Some of you might know me from Canada's Drag Race. Lots of people also know me as the Math Drag Queen on TikTok, where I do loads of educational content, riddles, lessons, all about math.
Here's a story of how a simple math mistake cost NASA $125 million.
So I downloaded TikTok one day. It was completely on a whim that I just did a couple of riddles and math story times on stuff that I personally thought was interesting, and turns out lots of other people found it interesting as well.
Have you ever heard that in a room full of 23 people, there's a 50% chance that two of them will share the same birthday?
So many people have this math phobia that is inherited from the way math is taught in schools, and I want us all to be able to unlearn it. Math really is beautiful, it really is elegant.
It's incredibly powerful in many different applications and thus necessary for navigating this world, especially in the digital age.
You can never trust graphs to tell you the full story, especially if the people behind them might have an agenda. But if I want to tell a story of volatility, all I have to do is use a very small range on my vertical axis, and suddenly every little change looks a lot bigger.
Really the hard part is finding out a way to explain it that is simple and interesting and correct. You have to sort of hit all of those three points. I really like probability. For instance, the Monty Hall puzzle is one of my favorites.
Let's say I've got three doors for you to choose from, and behind one of them is a brand new car, and behind the other two are goats. You choose a door. Let's say you choose this one. Before opening it, I will open a different door and reveal a goat behind it, and then offer you the chance to switch to the only other unopened door. Should you switch, stay, or does it even make a difference?
Turns out that by switching, you end up doubling your odds of winning the car. It just goes to show our intuitions can be so wrong and they can fall so short. And so thank goodness that we have math to remedy that. Where would we be without it?
What does the Fibonacci sequence have to do with flowers? How would you fairly cut a cake to share it between two people?
Let's talk percentages and sales.
My favorite thing about drag really is the artistry and the craftsmanship. I love being able to wear so many hats, from choosing the music and the performance and do my own makeup and hair and costuming. I like that I have so much control over what I present to the audience.
Attention fives, a 10 has just arrived.
Walking into the workroom on that first day, I had loads of fun, and all the friends that I made, I feel are the best part of the experience. It definitely did not go according to my evil master plan, that's for sure, but I learned a lot from it, and so I wouldn't have changed.